I wanted to show you this flyer.
Oh man, yeah, yeah.
So
wow, you still got that? That's
yeah.
That's gotta be.
I save a little bit of everything. That's about 13, 14 years old, I think.
Gotta be at least, yeah.
So on it, it was saying that all proceeds go to Wally Vinyl. So I know you had a situation where you had a fire, but I wasn't quite sure if it was to your home or your studio, and you lost pretty much everything.
Yeah, so it was a lot of confusion about what was really going on because the media was being bullied. So what really happened was I'm from North Charlotte, and North Charlotte for the longest was predominantly Black until, of course, they decided they wanted to start buying up and changing and bringing in the banking and the whatever. So in North Charlotte, there were these mills that were pretty reasonably priced. The city didn't know what it really had in that building, I don't think, at the time. So people could move there and set up life, family, whatever. So I lived there, Marcus Kaiser lived there, and a plethora of other creative people would get these loft-type apartments and families. And one day they decided that, now these buildings are historic mills, right? Predominantly brick, whatever. Mm-hmm. They come in one day and say, hey, the building is infested by termites. And the termites have destroyed the structure of the building so bad that if you stay in it, it's going to fall apart. You don't even have time to touch your stuff. You just got to go right now. And when they approached to tell us this, they had the police with them. So it was like, don't argue with us. Just grab what you need for the weekend and we'll figure the rest out next week. And that's just what it was. You just woke up one day. And of course, we knew it was BS. Like, there was very little wood in the structure of these buildings. And the wood that was there had been treated with tar and whatever else from way back when to make sure it was strong, sturdy, whatever. So long story short, man, we found ourselves living hotel to hotel and wherever for a pretty good while we fought to get property back because they condemned the building. They quote unquote condemned the building, even though if you go by there today, they've renovated the whole place. This is years and years later. Renovated the whole place, and they're selling and leasing them out for 10 times what we were paying back then to live there. And essentially, man, you know, the hip hop community, the community as a whole, the skate community, hip hop, the arts, whatever, came together and started trying to find ways to help different groups of people because it was like 60 or 70 some households that were displaced from this situation. And as the media was trying to cover it, we started finding out real quick that people in positions of power started trying to downplay it and put things out there like the families are good, they're taken care of. You know, I was an individual, so it wasn't as terrible for me as it was for some people who had wife, kids, granny, whoever, all staying on one roof, you know what I mean? But Eric and them came together with a few other hip hop heads and they organized and reached out to Lil Brother, Fonte, Pooh, Ninth, like Kazi, you know, like when you got the flyers, a ton of people.
Forge, Maze, Mr. Invisible, Pins and Needles, right. Ike, right. Charles Heron, Point right. Game again, rest in peace, Next Level Records.
Yeah. And cats just came together, man, for the love of, which was a true testament of, you know, some of these cats, we would go to war on the mic, but do anything for each other that we could within our power. Lil Brother came through, I think they were on tour and came off the road with their camp, you know what I'm saying, to come through and perform for free. Nobody asked for no pay, nobody asked for nothing, as well as the Charlotte team that was there, you know what I mean, the South Carolina artists that were there, like everybody that showed up just off the strength of there's something happening. We can do something about it, you know what I mean? And even when the money was broke down to me, I broke that, what was given to me, down to two others who were living in the mills as well, because I wasn't the only one going through it, you know? So it was like, if we can share this in as many different directions as possible, then let's do it. So, bro, I'm not an emotional guy, but it was one of those things that was really like, I had the one tear trying to come down the eye. So it was like, yo, cats really showed up, you know what I'm saying? And I respect it. I appreciate it, you know?
Well, it was an amazing show, and I was, you know, glad I could contribute however I could.
Hey, so, let me say thank you, man. I appreciate it.
No doubt.